Welcome to the 5G Things CTO Focus Session. And we will today talk about the necessity of high-performing, resilient, and sustainable 5G systems. We will focus on one of the key components, which is really high-performance, purpose-built hardware for advanced antenna systems and for massive MIMO systems. This is clearly a key part. 5G will require innovation across the whole ecosystem, from hardware, software to system design, and the close co-design of Ericsson silicon, our own purpose-built chip, with hardware and software plays a crucial role in delivering this high performance, energy efficiency, and therefore sustainable products. And this is in all deployment scenarios, from the wide area macro systems all the way into the indoor lightweight systems that will be the pervasive digital infrastructure of the future. Very welcome today to Lip Butan, former CEO of Cadence and now executive chairman and of Cadence Design Systems and chairman of Walden International. Hi Lip, welcome.
Yeah, thank you, Erik. It's great to be here with you.
You know, purpose-built hardware, it's really been key in the telecom industry already since we started. You could look at the journey from 2G all the way to 5G with advanced signal processing, high performance, high energy efficiency. All of this has been with us for a long time. And now we see this is happening across other industries, not the least in hyperscale cloud providers building unique purpose-built accelerators. But if we look at our industry, the 5G industry, high-performance 5G systems, they really bring limitless connectivity because of the advanced processing, because of the advanced usage of the spectrum, the 5G spectrum, and it's allowing us to enter not just the consumer market, but anything in the enterprise space, mission-critical systems, really high-performance systems. So we are on a fantastic journey to leverage both hardware and software going forward. What's your view, Lip-Bu, of where we are now in the industry?
And a couple of things. First of all, I think you mentioned about the wireless connectivity. It's played a very crucial role in terms of driving the high performance, low latency and power efficient and much broader bandwidth. And that's going to create a lot of new business model and application for throughout the world. And then clearly we are moving into a data-centric era. It's all about data and how do you connect the data, transmit the data, and process the data. And with the 5 generation wave, you know, led by 5G, AI, machine learning, data analytics, and hyperscale infrastructure, it really transformed the whole industry. And this is exciting time. And there's a tremendous need in terms of building the purpose-built silicon that is optimized specific workload for the various application. So this is exciting time.
Well, I already mentioned, and you said it as well, that it's an exciting time when it comes to innovation. And this foundation has been built for many decades now. Network capabilities have in fact grown exponentially for decades, about 100 times improvement every 10 years. So it's a fantastic journey all the way from 2G now with 5G and really advanced augmented virtual reality use cases, the app economy that was launched already in the 4G era. All of this, of course, is powered by advanced hardware. So how do you see the future now? If we look at the coming 5 to 10 years, perhaps, all the way to 2030.
Yeah, I think I completely agree with you. This is an explosive of data growth. And how to transmit and communicate and networking is critical for a lot of business. So I think 5G, 6G coming is really driving a lot of new innovations for our industry, especially in, like you mentioned earlier, the hyperscale cloud, and almost everything is on the cloud. And then now the next frontier is the edge. And then the power efficiency is very important. The data transmission is critical, and then 5G and 6G play a very important role in this whole data analytics and then drive better performance and throughput. And then power efficiency is very critical. So I think with that, I think clearly we had to continue doing innovations. And then on the semiconductor side, you know, clearly we see a very broad activity in terms of couple of areas. One, as you know, the Moore's law continue to drive the lower and lower and smaller geometry, from 7 nanometer to 5 nanometer, and now we are working on 2 and 3 nanometer, and that's increased a lot of complexity in terms of how do you squeeze that into that small geometry, the interference, the efficiency, and then the power that Moore's law can you continue to drive the power, performance, and area, and then the speed, and then that will be a very challenging area. So we are investing quite a lot on that. And then the other part is also it's very important to know, when you move that geometry down that small, and the 3D scaling, 3D, the packaging, advanced packaging become very critical, how to drive the power efficiency, and then also drive performance yield. Very important, when you move that geometry, if the yield is not high, and you're gonna be a lot of challenge in terms of cost. And then the other part is also you need to really focus on not just a silicon level, you have to really work on the software, taking a system approach, and not just a silicon alone, the packaging on the system level, and also on the whole system analysis modeling become very critical. So you want to provide the full stack of the solution to the customer. That I think is very critical.
So Lip-Bu, that's all great with development across both hardware and software and the system part. What about new compute paradigms?
The other part is the AI machine learning, and how do you drive the efficiency and then drive the better performance, and then also have a new insight into some of this performance. Give you one example, like medical drug discovery, and then how do you use that data with the clinical data to drive better, accurate treatment to the patient. So you move into kind of a personalized medicine, and that is very important. And also I think AI machine learning is applied across all the different industry. So the data transmission, communication wirelessly will be very critical. And I think you play a very important role on that. Then the next phase is the quantum computing. And that will be after the AI machine learning. There's already a few startup companies starting to really have a disruptive technology. They're able to bring very accurate and scaling solutions. And I'm just looking forward to the first commercialized quantum computing that we all can use. And that will be exciting. So I think back to your question, purpose-built silicon become more and more critical for system company and also the service provider to really drive, optimize their particular performance they're looking for.
So Lip-Bu, what's your view on the evolution of purpose-built hardware? If you look across industries, what is it really that is driving change here?
Yeah, a couple of areas. Back to my point on the system level, the design. And it become more and more critical. We work very close with a lot of system and service provider. And like Cadence, we have more than 45% of our customer are system company and service provider. And we get to really understanding their workload and their requirement. And they are very specific. And back to your point about power efficiency, it's very important for them. And then secondly, also the performance is very important to them. And then the other part is the security is very important. And then also I think the other part is the IP, because you can't do everything yourself. So how do you use the industrial standard IP and also some of the AI engine, like we have the Tensilica, and that turned out to be very helpful for them to drive low power, drive the AI machine learning, to really have the throughput they're looking for, the specific requirement to optimize their customized solution to their customer. And it become a very important competitive advantage that they're able to provide their customer with a really throughput efficiency that other people cannot offer. That customization become very critical for their differentiations.
So Lip-Bu, what else should we prepare for as an industry?
Yeah, a couple of areas that are very dear to my heart. You know, one is the new material. I think clearly the Moore's law with the CMOS, double the performance area and cost is getting to kind of slowing down to reaching the limit. And that's new materials requires, you know, the gallium nitride, silicon carbide, and then the indium phosphide. So I've been looking at some of the new material, how to drive in some specific application, the RF switch area. Gallium nitride is really good. And so I think it's kind of interesting to see that, you know, some new material innovation is very important. And then secondly, when you move down the geometry, you know, I think, as you know, supply chain is a big issue right now in terms of subscript shortage. And then when you move down even further, people are talking about new innovation on glass subscript. And that is a very interesting area. And then how do you make it to become truly efficient, have a higher yield, and it's cost effective? That is the next few years people are going to look at when you move down the geometry. And then the other part, I think you mentioned earlier, when you move to 5G to 6G, that whole RF antenna integration is going to be a big challenge. And that's, again, there's a lot of innovation on the semiconductor side. And then Cadence is very well positioned in terms of our strong RF mixed signal capability, or the various tools that we have. And then the other part is, Cadence, we are starting to move into, I call it the intelligent design, the system design. So we also focus not just on the silicon side, then we're starting to look at the system analysis and then how to drive better performance in the mixed signal and then how to scale that. So those are the part that we love to work, explore with you. I think those are the frontier of our joint challenges in the industry. Hopefully we can continue the innovation to drive better solutions for our mutual customers.
Yes, for sure, Lip-Bu. That's really an exciting development going forward here together. Great. And I think we witness that day by day, critical functions are moved into the digital domain and making the networks, the telecom networks, even more important for anything from consumer applications, enterprise applications, to society at large when it comes to mission critical performance. And to achieve this performance and also the energy efficiency in 5G, we rely on the Ericsson silicon, and it's at the heart of Ericsson's network platform. Given what we know about traffic growth and the exponential growth of traffic, not only by existing consumer applications, but also future XR applications, the enterprise demand coming online, we need to continue to optimize the silicon solutions. And that's also where we need further innovation. And that will be dependent truly on successful silicon development, software development, and collaboration across the ecosystem and the supply community. And this collaboration is really going to take us to the next level. It's crucial to meet the demands of future networks, high performance, optimized, and also sustainable networks. It was great chatting with you, Lip-Bu. Thank you so much for taking part in the CTO Focus session.
Thank you so much.
Now it's time to invite Per-Erik Möckelind, expert in advanced technologies in Ericsson. Welcome, Per-Erik.
Thank you, Erik.
Lip-Bu was into this a number of times, the importance of performance, energy efficiency. I'm thinking about our own Ericsson Silicon, where we are world leading when it comes to advanced processing, advanced antenna systems, MIMO systems, energy performance, bit rates, capacity, all of these things really part of our hardware and of course software. So what's your thoughts when it comes to power efficiency, energy efficiency?
I think this is an extremely important topic, Erik. We have not really understood how much more compute we are needing in the next generation and this coming generation's base station. A 5G base station with advanced antennas requires something like 20x more compute than the 4G base station. And this is nothing that Moore's law will help us with. We need to do very advanced design, optimize these systems to fulfill our requirements on energy efficiency.
And it has really become one of those key requirements coming from our operator customers. Sustainability, obviously top of mind for everyone, but also the energy bill, making sure that we can serve users, consumers, enterprises with the best performance and still keeping energy under control. So I think this is absolutely a must.
I agree.
Lippu, he was into it a little bit with 3D architectures. What's your view about chiplets and 3D stacking? What's ahead?
Yeah, I see this as a great opportunity because going down in semiconductor geometries, more advanced technologies, each tape out will come at a greater cost. Mm. And the chiplet and 3D stacking is an opportunity where we can combine small pieces of silicon into the same package to build the system in the package. And this will revolutionize the future going forward in semiconductor. And we see a lot of new initiatives from bigger players in the market in this area. So I'm really looking forward to this. We were maybe early adopters in this, but it has not been a multi-vendor ecosystem so far.
But I think you're right. This is where we need the ecosystem to work together. It will be something that over time need to combine kind of multi-vendor and the capabilities. But that also brings, I think, the last topic I want to touch upon with you, and that's optimization. How do we ensure that we use the best of hardware and software? Actually, even in a disaggregated world, what is it really that we need to think of when it comes to optimization?
I think we need to start with an overall system perspective. I mean, use what is best at each position. Mm. I mean, where there is a tremendous compute need and we have very specific algorithms, we should do very purpose-built. And when we are coming more to control processing, we should leverage other ecosystem in the industry. And I think sort of the hardware software co-design is a very important aspect, and this we have done all the way back since the GSM era. We have done our own DSPs, we have added very specific accelerators for the different radio algorithms, and we have done a software and hardware co-design, which has led to very efficient system designs. Mm.
Thank you so much, Per-Erik. I think this is going to be an exciting journey for sure over the coming 5 to 10 years on the hardware side with purpose-built, on the more general purpose, of course, as you touched upon, and of course also on the software side, building the systems that can handle all these requirements from consumers, enterprise, society. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Erik.
High-performance 5G systems require the best of hardware, the best of software, and the best of system design. I think we've today had an interesting discussion about where purpose-built hardware is going. We've also really looked at what society needs when it comes to even higher performance, higher energy efficiency, and also covering new deployment scenarios where 5G will be the pervasive digital infrastructure. Thank you so much for watching, and hope to see you back again.